morning and welcome to Calculus in the Air. I'm your host, Mr. Shindalka, and we're looking at optimization. Here's an example. Two positive numbers have a sum of 20, so they add up to 20. Find these numbers if the sum of their product and four times one of these numbers is to be a maximum. What's that maximum sum? Okay. It's important here because if I didn't have the first part of the sentence, two positive numbers, if I didn't have this, if I just said two numbers have a sum of 20, you could have 100 and negative 80 as possible numbers, right? But here, this limits it because you know it'll be 1 and 19, 10 and 10, 5 and 15, etc., right? Two numbers have a sum of 20. Even if they were possibly negative numbers, let's just say we've got to keep it to one variable to keep it simple. This is something I know even in grade 8 people get mixed up. Two numbers, so the first number, what are we going to call the first number? You guys are jotting this down. Give me a variable. Oh, come on, guys. X, sure. Creative. Okay, great. Now, let's just, because people often get mixed up on how to set up the second number. If the first number was, think of an actual concrete number, like an actual number. Give me a number that's less than 20.
Four.
If the first number was 4, what would the second number be?
16.
You just know this. What did you actually do arithmetic-wise to get that to 16? You said? Square.
20.
It is 4 squared, but that's a complete coincidence. 20 minus, right? And does that work if I had 7 and 13?
Yeah.
20 minus 7, okay, that's what you ask, because the square thing wouldn't work. 4 squared is 16, sure, but it doesn't work for the other one, right? So 20 minus that first number. You want to get it down to one variable, because I know often people will say, well, I'll call the second number y, but then you don't have this. It gets more complicated. It can be solved possibly. Okay. I've declared what the two numbers are. Find these numbers if the sum, okay, we know adding, right, the sum of their product and, so this is what we're going to try to create a function. I'm going to use green here. This is careful reading. So I'm going to just call this some function that we're going to create. If the sum of their product, I'm going to just write out the words here. Product sum and 4 times one of the numbers. It doesn't say which one. Okay. I'm putting that in there because this is where people get messed up. You can jump right to it if you can see it. What does the product imply? What's the mathematical statement for the product of the two numbers? The word product means?
Multiply.
X times 20 minus X, right? So the product will be X times 20 minus X. That would be 7 times 13, it would be 5 times 15, 10 times 10, whatever the two numbers are, right? And that would give you that. So if you have difficulties just jumping straight into X's, say to yourself, if this was 7 and 13, would that work? Yep, that would give me the product. Plus, it doesn't stipulate it has to be the bigger or smaller number, the first number or the second number. So if you could choose one of these numbers, which is the simpler one to put into the expression? Yeah. So 4 times one of the numbers, 4x. Don't make your life miserable. You'll get the same answers regardless if you chose the other number. But, okay. If you want, now that's just the function that gives you that. And it'll give you a, you could test this out with 7 and 13, you could test it out with 10 and 10, and so on. What is, We want to find a maximum, though. And how do we find maximums? Previous chapter, when it was just a function? Critical number. Find the critical number. And then you'll see if it's a max or a min, right? So I need to basically, before I do calculus, we should probably square things out or multiply things out and have a quadratic with squares. And then we'll do a derivative. Okay. So this is going to be 20x minus x squared plus 4x. I'm going to group like terms. I don't really care if the x squared is first or not. If it makes you feel better, put negative x squared. I'm going to just go with the 24x first. I like having positive things first. That's up to you. To find a critical number, as Ms. Jackson told us, we need a derivative. She didn't tell us that. She just said critical numbers, and I know she knows. So I do the derivative, 24 minus 2x. To find the critical numbers, state your derivative, set it to 0, and solve. I think you could probably just see this one. 24 minus 2 times something, that's 12. You saw the other number.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyways, where was I? 12. So if 12 is a critical number, how do we know that's a max? Well, it's the only critical number, so in a given word problem, it's probably the solution, and we can take a shortcut and just say yes. Do you remember, though, if you had to prove this was a critical number, you could do sign analysis, or you could do the second derivative with 12 in it. Just a quick mental check, though. What is the second derivative of that expression?
Negative 2.
What does that tell you? Oh, second derivative. Sad face, right? Doesn't that mean any critical number on there that you find is going to be a max, right? That's all that means. So you know for sure, and there was only one option in this. Sometimes, though, you will have an expression where you get two or three numbers, and you will have to figure out whether it's a maximum or minimum. That's why I'm just mentioning this. One way is to, if it's simple and quick, do the second derivative. Remember, happy face, sad face, you'll be able to tell quickly if it's positive or negative, whether it's a max or a min. Or you could do sign analysis. In this case, though, it's far quicker to do the second derivative. Anyway, we want, that's the first number. What did it ask for, actually? Did it ask for what the max value is? What is the maximum sum? It actually didn't ask what the two numbers are. But I think you could see quickly. The two numbers are 8 and 12, and then you could put it in there, or you could just use that function f of x. So the maximum sum occurs at x equals 12, so let's just use the function f of 12. And you'd say, well, that's equal to 24 times 12 minus 12 squared. Do some arithmetic. You got calculators, but I mean, this will be 24 times 12. Oh, it's really 2 times 12 times 12. So 144 doubled is, well, I know it's, I'm going to just think of this as 2 times 144 minus 144. You do it with your calculator. It's 144. Isn't it? Oh, yeah, it is. I'm just doing it in my head. That's why I'm doing it this way.
What did you plug it in?
Oh, the actual, the function that you created there. Or, if you wanted to and you just think, well, it's 12 and 8, you could have just thought from first principles, the product of 12 and 8 is 12 times 8, whatever that is, plus 4 times, we chose to be 12, so first number, right? And it would still add up to 144. So that answers your question. Always make sure, sometimes it is, what are the two numbers? So make sure you answer the question that was asked. It didn't ask what the two numbers are, so I don't need to state that. Sometimes it'll ask for both. What are the two numbers and what is the maximum sum? We'll try one other question, if there's no questions here. And then like I said, you guys got some finishing up and to do for the previous section. Okay? You guys are hoping to own a farm, you find this handy. Because I know farm kids do this all the time. In calculus, farmer must enclose a rectangular pen having an area of 270 meters squared. Material for the north and south sides of the rectangle costs $10 a meter. Material for the east and west sides costs $3 a meter. I don't know why. Maybe the one side you want to like look real fancy and it's like wooden boards and the other side's just wider or something like that. Find the dimensions of the rectangle that will minimize the cost of the fence. What's the minimum cost? Honestly, this is not a realistic situation, but if we jumped into realistic situations, there'd be so many factors. A store, and they'd say something like, they have to pay employees this, you know, amount, and there's 144 employees on the factory, and if they run it at this rate. Like, we use unrealistic problems only because they're easier to understand. And then if you ever choose to get into business or something like that, you would actually use far more complex equations, but the same principles, possibly to maximize profit, minimize cost in this case, right? So find the dimensions of the rectangle that will minimize the cost of the fence. So do we understand the problem a bit? Well, let's draw a rectangle, I guess, here. On the north, what does it say here? Material for the north and south sides of cost $10 a meter, the west sides are $3 a meter. Well, I'm gonna just declare the top north just because that's the way I usually think. Now, intuitively, if the north and the south sides of the rectangle cost $10 a meter, does it make sense they'll be shorter if you're trying to minimize cost? I don't care if you drew a square though, it would still solve. But I'm just thinking intuitively, I know what my answer should be. So north is at the top here. East and west sides are the more expensive sides. I did those in green. Now, we know a little bit about area. Length times width equals the area, right? Now, where do we go from here? You guys got some ideas? Well, if I call this the length because it's longer, right? And I know in general for the area of it.
Wouldn't the east and west sides be shorter?
Well, we want to minimize the cost of the fence. And the $10 a meter is for the north and south. So I guess I'll call this width here. The width we'd want short. But even if you drew it mistakenly the other way around, you'd still get the right answer. I'm just thinking intuitively, I'm going to have smaller sides. So what do you know about length times width? That's area. I think you guys knew that, right? What do you know about the length and the width in this particular case? They're equal in? Yeah. So L times W is 270 meters squared. I'll leave the units out because we've got enough letters as it is. Now, I put my letters colors backwards here. Not that that matters too much. If I'm using a system, I should keep to it. Now, let's just solve for width. It doesn't really matter which one I chose, right? So do you guys see where that'd be a second step? I could use my pen to pull it around, but always get it so that you have one variable only. So that width, and I chose width to solve for mainly because I have it right beside this width right here, right? That's I could have chose for the length and solve for it, 270 over W. Now, find the dimensions of the rectangle that will give me the minimum cost of the fence. Let's think about the cost function then. Because this is just relating, the area only relates length and width. So 270. If one was 27, the other's 10, right? Like this is how the function works.
Okay. Because you test it out with numbers. What's the minimum cost of the fence?
Well, the cost function. Cost is a function of L. And the reason why I'm choosing length is because I've solved my width in terms of length, and I have L. That's easy, right? Okay, but I might do this in two steps here, just so that we understand it. The cost is going to be equal to, so maybe right off the bat I won't have this as a cost function. Let's just do it in words here, more or less. $10 for the, what we called the, $10 for the width. $10 times the width, but how many times do you have to do the width? Top and the bottom, right, of my diagram, so twice. Does that make sense? So whatever it is, times two. And I'm going to add that to, what is it, $3 for whatever the length is. And I have to double that because there's two sides with that same length. Okay. Now I'm going to sub in for 270 over L, like for the width. And I'll drop the dollar signs, just to have a little less here. So the cost function. You don't have to make your C's so fancy. I used to work for Hallmark. 20. Now instead of W, I'm putting 270 over L, 6L.
Second.
Okay, I see I'm writing up on the one slope, and then here I'm writing down here. Whatever. Still crooked, but whatever. Before I do calculus on this, I'm going to multiply 20 and 270, so 2 times 27 is 54, so 5,400. And instead of over L, what's an easier way to think of this? To do calculus, you could put over L, but what's a simpler way to think of divide by L? L to the?
Negative one.
Yeah. Plus 6L. Why am I saying I need to do calculus? Well, I want to minimize costs, so critical number. Find where it's zero, see if that's a minimum, and then see what the width is. I'm going to do the derivative. I'll go, I'm going to restrain myself and go C prime, just a regular C prime of W with respect to the variable W. Why did I put W in here? Why didn't somebody ask me? Thank you. Okay. I just realized. Doing it with respect to W? Okay. C prime of my variable is length. The math was correct, just the notation is wrong. Okay. So, negative, you guys know how to do this, right? Negative 5,400. L to the subtract 1, minus 2. So over L squared, it's okay to jump to that. L to the minus 2 is over L squared. Plus, the derivative here is just 6. Okay. That makes it not too shabby. I'm trying to find the critical number, so I set it equal to 0, right? Essentially, then I move the 6 over, or I move the minus 5,400 over L squared over, either way. I'll maybe get this one. I'll maybe give myself a little more space. I need lightness. Do an old swap. Divide and multiply by each other. L squared. I got a calculator to do that. Take the square root. 5,400 divided by 6. Tell you what. That's 900. You could do it without a calculator, can't you? 54. Yes. So the square root is 30. But if you didn't see that, use a calculator. 30 is equal to the length. Now I've got to double check here. There's only one, so we're going to assume it's the minimum cost. Find the dimensions and what is the cost. So we've got two things. Now if I know this, you can go right back to an original equation and say what the dimensions are. But if you know that 30, what's the area supposed to be? 270. So can you just reason out that the dimensions are 30 times something makes 270, 3 times something makes 27, 9, right? So 30 and 9, and yeah, our hunch was right. It's shorter for the width, right? Okay. So we got 30 and 9. And the cost itself, we could use this cost function. Use the cost function if you want to do it from first principles with 30 and 9. Width and length. If you want to just plug it into this, you could do that. You've got a couple of options. Let's go with this one here. Okay, and since I've run out of space here, I'm just going to do it beside here. So then, the cost, when the length is 30, is equal to, I'm going to do it like this, 20 times 270 over 30 plus 6 times 30. See if I can do this in my head here, because that's 900. 20 times 900 plus 6 times 30. Because I don't want to get old and see 18. 6 times 3 is 8. Right? What did I do wrong? I know what I did wrong. 54. This is not. Yeah, that's. I'm just thinking that doesn't make sense. Sorry, guys. See? Use a calculator if you wish. I'm just trying not to. 180 again. 360. Yeah. And as we said, 30 and 9. So, to actually answer the question,
Now, 30 times 9, because that would be